So we have learned that the self inductance is dependent only on the permeability of the medium and geometry. Also, this is playing a role of inertia. So self inductance is very similar to inertia. So this is playing the role of inertia, and the EMF produced is called back EMF. Why it is called back EMF? Because it opposes any change in the current in the circuit. Now, since there is this back EMF or this self induction is playing the role of inertia, so we need work to be done against this back EMF, otherwise there will be no current maintained. So we have to do some work in producing some kind of current or in establishing the current. Establishing means if we want to produce current in a coil, so let us say this is our coil and we want to produce some current, so we have to do some work, otherwise what will happen, there will be a back EMF generated which will neglect this current. So we have to do work. This work is stored as magnetic potential energy. Which type of potential energy? Magnetic potential energy. For the current I at an instant in the circuit, the rate of work done is, now let us see this formula. So rate of work done, so how did we calculate? Work upon time is equal to power, and you know power is equal to VI. Here V is replaced by epsilon, that means EMF into I. So that's why we have written this dW upon dt is equal to epsilon I. If we ignore the resistive losses, so we are in assuming that resistance R is very low. So resistance, this is not radius, this resistance R is very low. So this resistance is very low. And consider only inductive effect. So let us discuss this thing. In any electrical circuit, we have only three components. First component is resistance. Second component is this capacitance. And third component is inductance. So inductance is shown like a coil. Resistance is shown as a zigzag. And this is the symbol of capacitor. So this is L, C and this is R. So this is called LCR circuit. Now what we are considering, since there is no capacitance, so this is not there. And we are also considering this R to be very small. This resistance is also very small. So we have only L component. This C was already not there. This R is very small. So we are considering only L type in this circuit. So we are considering only inductive effect. Then let us see what happens. So this was the equation. We are ignoring the resistive losses and we are considering only the inductive effect. Now let us put all these values. So dW upon dt is equal to, so what was the value of epsilon? So value of epsilon was, epsilon we had seen, this was epsilon was minus L dI upon dt. This we have calculated. If we put this mod, mod means we are considering only value, not negative or positive. So L dI upon dt. Because power cannot be negative. So hence we always consider power to be positive. So this is in mod. So we don't get a negative sign. So let us put this value. So L dI upon dt and into I. So this is L I dI upon dt. Now this is very small work done. So now let us calculate the total work done. So let us remove this dt and let us integrate both the sides. We are integrating both the sides. So total work done is integral over this small work done, and this small work done is LI DI, because dt dt cancelled out. So small work done is equal to LI DI. So let us integrate. Since So from where we are integrating, from zero to current I. That means initially we have a zero current and we are increasing the current to I. So the actual problem is how much work is done if we are increasing current in a coil from zero to I. So how much work needs to be done? So let us integrate. So integration is zero to I L I DI. Now L is a constant, so it comes out of integral. So we get this 0 to I L I, sorry, L is removed, I DI. Okay. And integral of I DI is, integral of this is simply I square by 2. Again, if we put this value, this is also I. So what we get? L I square by 2, half L I square. So this is the total work done in increasing the current from 0 to I. So total work done in increasing current from 0 to I is half Li square. Here what is the simplification? We have considered that there is no resistive term. We have only inductive term. If you see this, this is work done. And work done is equal to energy. Okay? If you remember the formula for kinetic energy, we have half mv square, this is half Li square. So this is very similar, both the formulae are very similar. So this is for kinetic energy, half mv square. And when particle has mass m, so here we see shows the L analogous to this. So L is electrical equivalent of mass. So mass is the property that produces inertia. Self-inductance is the property here that is producing effects similar to inertia. That is, L is electrical inertia. This is electrical inertia and opposes growth and decay of current in a circuit. So this L tries to oppose the growth or decay of current in any kind of circuit. So up to this point we have learned. Let me clear this. Now we have learned about self-induction and mutual induction. Now consider a general case of currents flowing simultaneously in two nearby coils. So we have two nearby coils and current is flowing. Currents are flowing in those coils. The flux linked with one coil will be sum of two fluxes exist independently. So instead of one flux, now we have two fluxes. So what are two fluxes? First flux, because of this self-inductance, this M1 means self-inductance. The coefficient of induction on coil 1 due to coil 1 itself. Now this M12 is coefficient of induction on coil 1 due to current in coil 2. So this is self-inductance. So this M1 is nothing but L, self-inductance. So this is the coefficient of inductance due to current in same coil, but this is coefficient of induction in coil 1 due to current in coil 2. Okay, so we have two parts. So first we solve for mutual inductance, M12 is equal to M21. Next case we have learned about M11, which was L. Now we are considering both the cases simultaneously, that means at the same time. So instead of one, we have two type of fluxes. One because of the coil itself and because of the nearby coil. Now let us see what happens in this case. So here M11 represents the inductance due to same coil. So M11 is same as L. So now let us write, so this, let us differentiate this one. So what was epsilon? Epsilon was simply, so they have written epsilon 1, that means EMF generated in coil 1. So we are not considering coil 2 here, but we are considering the effects of coil 2 in terms of the current. So epsilon is equal to minus N d phi b upon dt. And what is the value of this phi? Phi 1 is M11 I1. M12 I2. Okay, so let us put this values here. Now, since M11 is a constant, so it comes out of differential. So what we get? Di1 upon dt. Similarly, minus sign comes from here. Minus sign comes from here. And this M12 is again a constant, so it comes out of differential. And this I2 becomes Di2 upon dt. This and this are constant, so this comes out of differential. Di1 upon dt minus Di2 upon dt, and minus sign because of this. So this is the formula that we get. So this is the EMF introduced in coil 1 due to self-inductance and mutual inductance. Now again, as we have already learned, this M11 is nothing but L1, or I have written simply L. Now let us write 1 because this is for the first coil. Similarly, we can produce for second coil, equation for second coil. So this epsilon 1 is equal to nothing but minus L1, M11 is L1, so minus L1 Di1 upon dt minus M12 Di2 upon dt. Suppose we have to write the same equation for coil 2. So how can we write? So epsilon 2 is equal to minus L2, this self-inductance in that coil, current in that coil is Di2, current in that coil is I2 upon dt minus, this coefficient will change. This coefficient will become M21, and this current is now because of I1. So Di1 upon dt. So this is the EMF introduced in second coil. This is the EMF induced in first coil. Again M12 and this both are same. So we can replace these by M. Okay. So this is the EMF induced, but this is the general case where self-inductance and mutual inductance both are taken together.